Any of it, I digress. Yes, if there's anything that you can do, let us know it is for the benefit of your child. That is it. Player profile day, again, that's the technical testing. I've had a comment from some teams. I'll make an example, it wasn't this many for me, but four or five players injured at once, we struggled to build a team. And I'm kind of thinking, well, you know, we can do warm ups and just cool down and have injury prevention programs here and grounds to me. There's so many things that go into four or five players injured at once and not being able to build a team. So, Christ's words being one of them, why I mentioned this. So, we check for the height and weight. All the players that are 30 to 40 year olds that go through a growth spurt growing pains, but why do you want to come back from such a thing? Because his heel hurts, growing pains, come back. Why do you back? Why do you go back if you have grown too fast, too soon? It's great. But that's when you get injured. If you're injured, you're out for 6 months, probably. Okay, so just that extra level of professionalism that we want to do. No one's expecting it, and no one's asked for it, but the club wants to do it, and we'll give it a go. And I'm sure. We will report back to you, so coaches know that we'll be reporting back to you in terms of your child's development. Again, it's that little extra thing that no one's expecting, but we'll do it when we just need you guys to work with us.
Just talking about the weight situation, just from a girl's point of view, I really don't think that should be a focus because they already struggle with the weight.
Sure, no, I agree with you. So with the girls, there is external lab. The girls' coaches have not been asked to go somewhere else. They will be coaching, training here and playing here. They won't be the external lab. During the trials, when I had that video session with my daughter, when I recorded them, I had the girls, it was too much for them. I said, don't worry. Because I get there's a separate sort of expectation that we need to meet. And weight is one of those ones that we won't do with the girls.
So, both
of
you support
me,
but I just think the weight is a bit of an issue with a lot of the girls.
Oh, I agree with you, and it won't be
done. So can I say it's not just girls?
Yes,
I think there are some boys. I'm just saying, I think that when you do the weight should be done privately.
Absolutely.
And not exposed to the other child.
Yeah, so the height and weight will be done privately. And nobody knows the results. All that's used for is let's just say, and I'll tell you why I would be a weight. It's not really a football metric. If I tell a true football person, weighing football players, I'll be like, well, how's that football metric? How's it weighing your weight? The only reason I'm doing it is because I have a player who's actually underweight and he's moving into the 12s and the 13s. And I've been harping on to him. It's like my own kid. Because now he's moving from 12 to 13 to 14, and physicality is an issue. He used to be pushed off the ball. He's a young athlete, boy, used to be here. His name is Walid. Some of you probably know him. I've been asking him all year, and he's not listening to me. He's like, and I can see him. He's one of the kids that was in 12 to 13, and he was so far off, he couldn't go up an age group because of the player. But he's so far off, that's the motivation. Well, not so much the top end, but also the lower end, and at 12 and 13, I'd love them to be able to see the point. I'm trying to go on this direction, this is my end, and here is the progression. Okay, so that's all it is. It's not a problem that you play a great review. And now that we're talking about this, if you don't want to do it, as in the weight, it's cool. You don't have to do it. But if there is some sort of monitoring that one does, so, personally, I'm of the weight intake, I'm wearing the player GPS heart rate monitor, so I think it's the best. You don't change. And again, it's not to monitor, it's just habits, so that he knows, well, this is being done, and, he asks questions about nutrition, and it gives him suggestions as to what he can do, and how he recovers. Again, it's not for his performance, it's mainly just for him to set expectations. At this age of the year, it's sort of getting that height and weight. But again, if you don't want to do it, that's fine, I'll work with you guys. But why I'm doing weight is because of what I do. And if that applies to you, if you've got a certain weight goal, then that's good. If you don't want to do it, that's good.
Okay.
Mainly it is, I won't talk about this yet, but mainly it is the football metrics that I want to be recording and getting somebody in, not because we want to, but especially because I want to, sort of help kids work on this style of shot or pass. That's what I think. Uniform sizing will be, uniforms will be handed out once all the fees have been paid. We're looking at February for now. The club has modified its policy with respect to fees. They've now got installment plans. We get it, it's not easy. We've got, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 kids playing here. But from a club's perspective, it has certain costs, insurance, referees. There's a lot of what you can really pick up later. But we just need all fees to be paid up in February. That's when you get your uniform. So start paying it now. You've got 3-4 months, whatever it is, up until February to have it all paid out. You're paying installments. They've done that for you guys because we appreciate it. It's not easy. And we want to be working with you and retaining you and make it easy for you over the next number of months. If you want to pay in 1 month, so it's up to you. The policy, and just get all fees paid up until February. There will be some more information about this after the AGM. I've made this up, just installments. It's just a lot easier to do installments, and I guess the key thing there is by February it's paid up. Again, this is just made up. Don't hold me to this, but I just want to highlight that it's a bit easier to do a couple of months. Working with pitch D&E is a problem. If you're able to help, speak to the committee, speak to myself. We need that done. It's kind of critical. Otherwise, we'll all end up there. And as I said to the coaches, I don't believe that pitch will hold up, given the amount of traffic that we'll have. So, it's got to be 7 out. Trying to get external hire, trying to get pitch D&E done, asking for help. Speaking to the council, come June, if the pitch is, it's too late, so we've got to work. Avondale will play on mud, that green gully will play on mud for 4 or 5 months, the grass is gone. There's no grass, it was mud, it was compact, it was nice and smooth. But there's no grass. So this is an issue. If you can help us fix it, the time is now. Come June. I would have already asked coaches, yourselves, to help out, external hire. It doesn't happen. It's an afterthought. It's just not going to happen next year. The gym, I've been speaking to Mike saying, more so for this group. So my experience with the 2013 is the kids weren't good enough. I'm trying to get the gym at a cost-effective rate, especially on Sundays, 10 to 3:30, women's only. So after your games, go to the gym when you go to the pool. Still in the pipeline, it was supposed to be done 3 weeks ago. He said to me it was supposed to be done 2 weeks ago. Still not done, but that's just what we're working with behind the scenes. I want to work with YMCA here and the futsal centre, which is what I'm saying. So there's benefits there for you guys moving forward. There's nothing more I like seeing, and I'll tell you what my aim is. My aim is when my kids are the age of that kid here in the back, get you. When he's your age, I want him to look physically fit. I care much for, in terms of his appearance, I want him to have a presence. That's just going to make me so happy. When my kid rolls up to the ground, I care if he plays well or plays badly, he's a good person, he's looking physically fit, job done. Okay? 16 hours a week I spend on football. I drive from Templestowe, 2.5 hours to get there because I pick up some kids on the way, 2 hours to drive back because there's less traffic. 3 hours there during training. My kids train for 3 hours. 1 hour I take the 4 kids that I take to dinner 4 nights a week. Yeah, and next year I'll go 7 days a week. I don't do it for fun. I've had 2 heart attacks and I want to see my kid, that kid's age there, and I want them to look great. Yeah, and my job done. Right, so speaking to the gym, it's for your kids. Aims. My Acura was strong aim to short-term, medium-term, long-term aims. Let's not run around without an aim. One of my pet gripes about the way I live my life is I never had a mentor and I never had somebody to bounce questions off. Yeah? One, football is a year-on-year thing. This year you're a foreman. I want you to have an aim, a short-term, a medium-term, or a long-term one for this year, not for your life, for this year. The long-term can be a long one, but let's work on the short-term and medium-term goals, because my eight-year-old does it in class, and there's our classroom over there, and let's just try again. Okay? It's all about being a better person. It's not so much about football 100% of the time. It's about having aims in football and aims in life. I'm sure you've got it in school, because I'm sure you've got them in life, I'm sure your parents have them as well. Let's have them here as well. Okay? So something that we'll work on as we go on. Again, nobody's expecting it. Two trainings in the game, these are all veterans. Okay, so essentially that's all I've got for today. This is where to set the expectation for next year. Okay? Any questions, general questions you can ask as a group. If you want to email, you can email me. Phone calls I try to pick up, if not, I call back. If I don't reply to your SMS, it's because I have not an answer. And I'll be working on the answer to take screenshots, email to you, every time I see one on the computer. I'll put it there as an email, an SMS, if the questions being asked. So you can ask me anytime. If you don't ask questions, you've got a problem. You end up frustrated, you end up angry, and you end up probably meeting the club at the end of this year. Cool. So,